I just want to start this off by showing you the sketch that I used to plan everything, and I've watched Ready to Glare or Julia for a really long time, so I wanted this painting to be something really special. These are the images I used. They're sourced right from her Instagram, and pretty much everything that I use has been referenced from there. I don't like sticking too closely to references, and I am a very impatient person as well, so I go right into sketching out the underpainting, or my acrylic underpainting, I'll go into oil later, of my painting right on the canvas. I'd like to do a layer of acrylic underneath everything just to really get out all of my ideas. I feel like it really speeds up the process as well. There are a lot of reasons why I admire her, and especially with this concept, I don't want to make it seem like I'm glorifying her, even if the painting does kind of make it seem like that. I just wanted to showcase how I see her personality and style in the coolest way I could possible. Her veil is lifted, she is more than she would appear to be, and she's proud of it, is basically what I was trying to say. As someone who is also very passionate and determined in my academics, her experience with IB classes and intense school environment really resonated with me, despite the fact that all too often people assume that individuals with tattoos or brightly dyed hair, like my own hair, are the opposite. It gives me the courage to believe that you can be yourself unashamedly and still be pursuing an honest career where you deserve to be treated seriously. Of course, I understand that certain professional environments call for certain attire, dress codes, etc. But growing up, I didn't realize that being a professional didn't mean giving up personal expression. Her take on college as someone who is entering college, and here I start in on the oil portion and going over the acrylic layer. Her take on college as someone entering college is also something that I greatly admire. I truly want to pursue art as a career, and I realize that oftentimes collegiate communities fall prey to becoming echo chambers. And she's discussed this in, I believe, a recent video as well, with her own college experiences. And sometimes political opinion unnecessarily becomes involved in even unrelated subjects, such as an English 101 class, which I believe she was putting together herself to be as apolitical as possible. This is something I also really admire. I feel like there are far too many people who are in the mindset of, if you don't agree with blank political opinion, don't even talk to me, or we can't be friends if you believe this, because it really narrows down someone's view of the world. I grew up in a conservative community, yet I developed many more liberal beliefs. I find myself, however, gravitating more towards the center, and I haven't really seen a lot of people on YouTube who do talk openly about politics identify with that, really. However, I don't watch a huge variety of people on YouTube, so that might be a reason why. Just went back into her face with my oil painting, and just to, for one thing, be more cost effective with my oil paints, because oil costs less than acrylic, and I try to conserve it wherever I can, but I still did want to smooth out the areas of her face that didn't look as blended as I would want, and to try to give it a softer, more ethereal appearance, almost like classical paintings you would see in an art history class. Her aesthetic is also something I greatly admire, just because of how open she is to different styles and even her experimentation with makeup to go into more gore costumey makeup and brightly colored wigs and her restyling it and how confidently she can wear fashion that I think looks beautiful, but I don't know if I would also have the confidence to wear. So yeah, those are just the reasons why I really wanted to paint this as a tribute to someone that I've been watching for a while. The reason for the concept behind this painting, I would say, would probably be sourced from the art history class that I took in the past year. We studied a lot of Leonardo's Madonnas, like the version of the rock, and, or version of the rocks, excuse me. I feel like she symbolizes a very reasonable point of view, but not necessarily the most conventional, which is why her veil is brightly colored. She's not holding a Christ child, she's holding a severed head. I wanted to speak to her personality, but also to the type of presence I feel that she has on YouTube. Not necessarily as someone who is godly, such as girl defined or something. In fact, I feel like my painting speaks to the opposite of that, kind of. But something that is reasonable and very influential, yet still very defined by personality and style, and something very unique to herself. If that made sense, I hope that made sense. Yeah, I made a few mistakes here, and you will probably see those as I'm going over this again. And I accidentally skipped over footage of me splattering paint, but this is the final product, and I am very proud of it. I've been watching YouTube for a long time, ever since I was maybe 10 or 12, maybe. And I've always wanted to have a YouTube channel, but I've never really been sure if I had to do it. But I've always had a huge passion for painting. So I suppose by painting the people I admire, and I might even make a series about this, painting like the YouTubers that I've been watching recently, and maybe even YouTubers that I've been watching in the past, I can give my channel some more direction and hopefully show you guys some more of the stuff that I can do. So yeah, if you'd be interested in seeing more of that, then please stick around. So thank you for watching, and this has been my painting of Ready to Glare. Thanks.